Hey guys, it's Michelle from the Air One Morning Show, coming to you a little bit differently. I'm in the car. I was totally planning on doing this outside, but it's summer in the South and that ain't happening. It is way too hot. So I'm in the car, I've got the air conditioning on, and we're all gonna be better for it. But I want to encourage you today for you to know that God wants to be your friend. The same God who created the universe, created the world, created you, wants to know you, wants to know your heart, wants to be in relationship with you. God sent his only son to die for us that we may know him. Jesus calls us his friends. He laid his life down for us. And in John, he says, there is no greater love than that. And when we stop and we think about all that he has done for us, and then that he wants to hear from us, that he wants us to lay down our burdens at his feet, to surrender all to him. I mean, it's just incredible. But just like a friendship that you have, whether it's at school or at work or nearby where you live, all the different friends in your life, relationships, they take work, they take communication. When we don't hear from someone for a while, we think, oh, are we still friends? Did I make them mad? What happened? And it's the same with Jesus. He wants to hear from us throughout the day when things are going well. He wants to hear all the things that we're grateful and thankful for. And he wants to hear our struggles, our fears, our anxieties, our worries, the things that we're going through. He wants to know us and our heart. So I just want to encourage you that you can take those steps to get closer through prayer. And I don't know what your prayer life looks like, and if I'm honest about mine, it's not always great. Sometimes it's amazing, and then other times I might go that couple of days or a couple of weeks and I'm like, what is going on? Oh, I'm not walking as closely as I should. So I just want to encourage you, whatever you're doing, whether you're worshiping with us, whether you're commuting to and from work, you're driving the kids around, you're at the gym, you're in a good mood, bad mood, indifferent mood, it's always a good time to be talking to Jesus. And he's always there to listen when we talk. And I don't know, sometimes, you know, my prayer life is so good, I'm sure he's like, oh, I'm like, hey, it's me again. I'm so sorry, I forgot. You know, whatever it is. But the more and more that we're in prayer and the more that we talk to Jesus, the closer our relationship is. I have some best girlfriends in my life. Dan is one of my best friends. But you know, since I've developed my relationship with Jesus, he's now the first person that I go to. When I have problems, when I have worries, when I have issues, I talk to him first. And that doesn't happen overnight. That doesn't happen when you first become a Christian. I wasn't raised in a Christian home, so this is a lot of stuff I've had to learn. And I want to encourage you with this song. And I don't know if you've heard it. It's not a song that Air One plays, but maybe you've heard it like I have, and I love it. It's called Talking to Jesus by Elevation Worship, featuring Brandon Lake. And I just want to share some of the lyrics, because maybe you're listening right now and you're like, I don't even know where to begin, or how do I, you know, pray the right things? And so I hope that these few lyrics really speak to you and encourage you. There's no wrong way to do it. There's no bad time to start. It don't have to sound pretty. Just tell him what's on your heart. 'Cause it's not a religion. No, 'cause it's more like a friendship. So just talk to your father like you are his kid. Just start talking to Jesus. I hope that encourages you. And we just want to say thank you so much for choosing Air One and for worshiping with us.